I've always said that if you wanted to send a message to the Republican Party, the best way to send that message to them was through their wallets. And that is exactly what some of the Republican Party's biggest donors decided to do over the weekend. Now, we had already talked about the fact that Josh Hawley had lost his biggest donor, a guy out in Missouri who had given him over $4 million for his first campaign, which basically amounted to about half the money that Josh Hawley had raised for his first Senate campaign. His donor spoke out about Hawley's challenging of the Electoral College, said, "I will not support this anymore. You just lost me." After that, JP Morgan, Citigroup, Goldman Sachs, Marriott, all announced, "We're not giving any more money to the Republican Party." Some of them said they're not giving any more money to the Republican Party or the Democratic Party for at least 6 months. Some of them said we're not giving anything to the Republicans. Others said we're not giving anything to the Republicans who objected to the Electoral College votes. Either way, really bad news for Republicans. But let me tell you something else. This announcement, the fact that they're able to make this announcement and it's going to have an effect, that's the worst thing for American democracy. These corporations understand how much power they have over us. And so just four of them got together and like, you know what? What if we just don't give them money anymore? That'll get them to do what we want them to do. And it will, because that's how the system works. That's how the cycle works. Look, we just came off of an election. And I know we're all suffering from a little bit of election fatigue, but these politicians turn right back around and start raising money for their next run. I mean, the House of Representatives, those elections are 2 years away now. Like, it's right around the corner. They have to start raising money. And losing the financial well of these companies here is going to significantly hurt them. So they're going to have to shape up and do whatever it is that JP Morgan or Citigroup or whatever want them to do. But that's not how the system should work either. Look, I am all for Republicans changing the way they are. I'm also all for getting rid of any and all corporate money in our politics, 100%. And I do not believe that withholding corporate money is the tool we should use to force Republicans to do whatever it is they're trying to get Republicans to do here. Corporate money has no place in politics. And that's what this story is really about. Yes, haha, it's funny. Republicans are losing money from their corporate donors. Great, that's wonderful. Democrats are too. Cool. We don't want them to be taking banker money anyway. But at the end of the day, these bankers withholding their money from these individuals is going to force these individuals to change their behavior, but it's not going to be change their behavior to benefit us. It's going to be change their behavior to benefit these corporate donors. That's the problem. That will always be the problem until we get corporate money out of politics forever.